Добрый день, уважаемые коллеги. С огромным удовольствием приветствую всех участников
форума. Good morning, dear colleagues. I'm very happy to welcome you from a city on the Volga River. I have to confess, in my 20 years of experience as radiotherapist, I haven't seen none of primary pleural mesothelioma. I had two patients with palliative care and pain syndrome, because this is a very rare and very aggressive tumor in asbestos-induced. It could be due to some errors in diagnostic, because mesothelioma can be confused with other
Видимо, отношение это достаточно
прохладное. For treating of pleural mesothelioma. The true scale of the incidence of PM in Russia is not known, because there are single and very limited epidemiological surveys. But something we may see the peak of mesothelioma in Western Europe, and it's expected that one quarter of a million will die of asbestos-induced mesothelioma for the coming 35 years. But in the Soviet Union, huge volumes of asbestos were manufactured, 2.3 million tons, which is half of the global production, compared with the United States in 1984, but less than 60,000 tons were produced. So we may expect the peak of the growth of pleural mesothelioma in the former Soviet Union republics, because it takes 30 to 40 years on average for the disease to develop, and we may see the peak in the recent future. Because of that, we must accurately understand how to treat this insidious disease. Any aggressive tumors may logically require to have multimodal and more aggressive treatment to liquidate the tumor. When it comes to prospective studies for radiotherapy in pleural mesothelioma are very limited. Retrospective studies produce this cognitive dissonance. See, on one hand, adding irradiation improves the outcomes. However, it is possibly not to the radiotherapy, but it is due to the patient selection, because they were selected based on the prognostic criteria, like expected survivability, the size of tumor, and if everything looks positive for the patient, then it is logical to intensify the treatment and have better outcomes.
Indeed,
considering the retrospective studies, and you see the table of these surveys, mostly done in the first decade of the current century, you see that authors got rather good results when it comes to the survivability median. Two and a half, three, or even five years of survivability in the case of Canada. This is great for the aggressive tumor. One study shows that the total population of treated patients, the median, was 16.6 months. However, after the extended surgery as extrapleural pneumoectomy, then the survivability grows to almost 22 months. And if radiation for half a chest is added, then it's almost 30 months of survivability. However, it's not the case that massive aggressive treatment will give the massively great results for the majority of patients. It is due to the pre-selection. Prospective surveys of radiotherapy for mesothelioma. The outlooks are great. Meta-analysis of five prospective studies, 1995-2017. So there were factors, local irradiation after a limited intervention, including biopsies done for verifying the PM, only randomized studies to compare whether what the benefits of adding or excluding irradiation, and also the frequency of relapses in the area of intervention. So the outcomes adding irradiation gives no benefits in the zone of intervention. Well, there was a trend for improved outcomes. However, these results are out of statistical control.
Overall,
how do we consider the first level of evidence for using irradiation? MARS, 50 patients in the UK and 12 centers. First chemotherapy, and then there was randomization either for extrapleural anectomy and irradiation. So the adding this irradiation just reduces the survivability, increases lethality. So the survivability was 14.4% compared to 19.5 in control group. Therefore, pleuroectomy, EPP is not recommended to resectable tumors, and pleuroectomy decortication is still used only in trials. Another research, SAC17/05, from German and Swiss doctors, 54 patients received initially a neoadjuvant chemotherapy, cisplatin plus pemetrexed, then surgery, EPP, for the full macroscopic resection, and then randomize either for irradiation, doses of 56 grays, and again, adding this local irradiation brought no benefits for overall survivability and survivability free of relapses. And again, radiation shall not be used as adjuvant to chemotherapy or surgery. However, researchers were still were looking for using irradiation for newer adjuvant stage, for example, SMART approach, to prevent the spreading of tumor cells during EPP. The challenge, it is toxic. Doses required for eradication are quite high, 54 to 50 grays as a minimum, highly toxic because of the huge volume, irradiation volume. Therefore, researchers stopped at smaller doses, small fractions, 5 to 6 in sequence, 25 to 30 grays. The research on this slide in Canada, published in 2016, indeed shows quite a good response. However, the frequency of lethality and pneumotis of fourth stage were quite fourth and fifth stage were quite high. So irradiation is quite toxic, and that's the main challenge. Half a chest has to be irradiated, and lethal pneumonitis seemed small, 1.5-2%, fifth and fourth stages, but 20% had pneumonitis of third stage. This is very high. Currently, there are several multicentral research stage 2 and 3 to assess irradiation via IMRT after chemotherapy or pleuroectomy decortication to consider whether it works for increasing overall survivability and disease-free periods. Whether irradiation can be used in the future and be used more often and regularly in treatment? To answer this question, consider always two points, several points. And this is the expert opinion recently published from several oncological communities last year, published in the Journal of Thoracic Oncology. IMRT, VMAT, tomotherapy are the best candidates because they are advanced technology delivering high dosages, 50 grays and above, and they do not affect the intact lungs and even deliver SIBs.
Second point is that this very difficult treatment has to be made in highly specialized centers where they really know how to do it. Our Turkish colleagues compared the two methods, tomotherapy and VMAT. The table to the right is not legible, but believe me, all the parameters regarding saving the organs, homogeneity of the dose distribution at the low-cost tomotherapy is a bit better than VMAT. However, the authors made a conclusion that both methods may be used with potentially lower risk of complications like pneumonitis. Radiotherapy, palliative ones, is definitely useful and efficient. We know that roughly half the patients with PM shall react to small radiotherapy up to the development of a complete effect. This is approved by the British authors who radiated patients with group. They worked with a group of 54 patients, a short course, 12 fractions of 36 grays. Standard palliative course, and the response rate was over 40%. If surgery is conducted, it's considered to be CT reductive. The visible tumor is left. Radiotherapy may be useful. At the last ESTRO Congress in the year 19, at the session late breaking abstracts, there was provided a randomized research made by Italians with 108 patients after cytoreductive surgery plus chemotherapy. They were randomized into the bigger radiotherapy for half the chest, 50 gray plus boost at the residual tumor, and it was compared with the local radiotherapy, just the residual tumor plus the scar. So this bigger, toxic, more toxic radiotherapy gives better, twice as good remote results, and the better 2-year general survival. But the price is pneumonitis, third grade or high in 1/5 of the patients. However, Italian authors suggested this method to be a new standard of treatment after the cytoreduction surgery. In general, the role of radiotherapy at pleural mesothelioma with a high level of evidence, use the clinical recommendations of ASCO, published in Clinical Oncology, a journal on the year 18. Radiotherapy as an effective modality may be recommended for palliative treatment of symptomatic patients in palliative doses or in case of asymptomatic local recurrence. Adjuvant irradiation of half the chest after cytoreduction surgery may be recommended in specialized centers. As for the adjuvant irradiation of half the chest after the radical surgery, as well as the nail adjuvant approach, may be done, but only in highly specialized centers and within the clinical research. research, clinical studies. So far, it's not a method of radical treatment. One should consider a different method of local impact, TTF, tumor-treating fields or electric fields that impact the tumor cells like chemo drugs. They break the connections of highly polarized tubuline subunits and cause apoptosis. They first mentioned it when treating glioblastoma of brain. This method, added to standard treatment, enabled to improve the remote results, like, for example, the 5-year survival. Earlier, this was non-achievable with standard methods. Hence, an idea came to use this method more widely, including the treatment of MPM as well. Last year, in Lancet Oncology Journal, they've published the results of the so far only prospective STELLAR trial with 80 patients, non-resectable mesothelioma, received cisplatin and pimetroxen, and that was combined with a TTF, a frequency of 150 kHz, no less than 18 hours per day after chemotherapy, and TTF was continued till the progression. This was compared with the historical results of just chemotherapy in the same case. So TTF addition enabled to improve general survival, median general survival, by 1.5 times, and the 2-year survival turned out to be twice as good. The side effects were minimum, just dermatitis that was easy to stop. After the research results were published, FDA approved TTF for MTM treatment in combination with chemotherapy. One should remember about this method and expect more research in this field. That's it with my presentation. Thanks a lot for the attention. Good luck to all the forum participants.